My dear brothers and sisters, what should we be busying ourselves with? What should we be busying our time with during these 10 days, which are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? First and foremost, we should be turning to Allah in repentance for our sins and for our past. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a clean heart. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a remorseful heart for the sins of the past. After that, focus on the wajibat, the fara'id, that which Allah has made obligatory upon each and every single Muslim. There's no point in devoting yourself to ibadah, in that which is voluntary, if you're slacking off on that which is obligatory. It doesn't make sense. If you're not getting up for Salatul Fajr and you're praying after its time, what is the point of praying nawafil? And I was just told that there are some youth today who are still not coming for Jumu'ah, and they're praying Jumu'ah at home, even though the masajid have opened. Salatul Jumu'ah is obligatory upon each and every single male who has reached the age of puberty. And we have no excuse, because the masajid are open and more than one Salatul Jumu'ah is available. And so we need to focus on that which Allah has made obligatory upon us first. After that, move on to those acts which are mustahab, which are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the extra nawafil. Whether it be salah, whether it be fasting, whether it be sadaqah, whether it be a dhikr. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, Ibn Hajar, he talks about why these days have been made special. And he says, it seems that the reason for why the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah have been made special is because the prime acts of ibadah come together in these 10 days. And he says, As-salah, fasting, sadaqah, and hajj. And we can add to that, proclaiming tawheed. The hujjaj, they're proclaiming tawheed. What are these? These are the five pillars of Islam. They come together in these 10 days, he says, and that is not the case with any other days of the year. And so work hard in these days and do not be from among those who are deprived of the mercy of Allah, of the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For this is an opportunity of a lifetime. Don't delay it. Don't say, I have next year, I have many years ahead of me. But rather, consider these days to be your last opportunity, for no one, no matter who he is, can guarantee himself to live for even another day.